So back to Matter. Yet another way to animate in Angular. I'm Douglas Duteil. I'm 24 years old. I had my graduation last year, and just after that, I joined Sphere. And actually, when I was at university, I was already hacking on Angular, and I ended up in the Angular UI community doing some projects. I'm actually really like partying, dancing, and my enterprise noticed it. So as first mission, they gave me an awesome project to participate in. That was a website with a lot of things, awesome, exploding from everywhere. But the code kills me. It was a month ago, I remember, back to Angular 101.5. And the animate was there, but they weren't using it. And they were making some kind of strange post-processing around ng clicks to end the first animation, then changing a state, and making really, really big directives, like huge, to handle all kind of thing. And when I asked the dude, why not ng animate it, he told me, no. Oh, it wasn't there from the start. We wouldn't add it just for you. So I was really frustrating. It was very frustrating. But at the same moment, I tried to discover something cool, really cool. Do you know about the web animation API, the spec? No? It's actually something I discovered through Polymer, because they have it in their platform system. And there is actually an extra repo, like a lot of repo around it. There is the web animation JS, there is the actual normal one on my side, and the next one that is a refactoring of it. And just to present it, it have really awesome features, like a parallel and sequential built-in system, so you can have this kind of duration calculation for free. You can access to a lot of things in player, so you can really play with it, the animation actually. And there's some kind of unification of all the actual animation system that's actually available on the browser. So it's very cool. Like, very, very cool. Just to present it, it's not far from what we know in CSS3. It's really, really easy to go in. There's the same kind of parts, just that you have to select the elements directly. This is actually a shortcut for this, when you can actually have the animation itself a part of the moment it's played. And talking about the player, it have a lot of more things than what you have in CSS3. Can not just play and pause, but reverse, force finish, force console. You have finish event that you can use. And you can seek an animation. So you can seek a frame in an animation. So you can say, I want this frame in an animation. And beam, you have it. For the grouping system, you can do all sorts of things in it with it, and it's really reusable. And you can give functions to your animation, like make custom one and some building one where with SVG, so you have a path in SVG and you can animate any HTML elements through this path given in SVG. And you can actually do your all custom things. So you can definitely synchronize a canvas with HTML elements with an animation, sequential, parallel, anything. So it's killing it all. It's killing all. It's so awesome, but the day after I discovered it, I was like, I should add it in Angular. I should do it. It wasn't there. So I was on fire. So here comes the WaAaAaa. I name it WaAaAaa because it's web animation and Angular. So, you know, easy. Actually, the idea, more than that, was having some kind of skeleton animation, like for 3D models. When you are animating 3D models, you have an editor that will output big set of data that will say how your animation have to go. And you just have to plug those data to a model to make it animate. And the second idea was having functional classes, so having the possibility to not just trigger an animation like predefined, but adding config to it, so it's some kind of custom content, contextual animation. All began with this hack, because I didn't want to use the .animate or .animation that was there. I want my WaAa animation. So I was able to add my model WaAa animation for that. For the skeleton things, this is just some kind of dummy code, but that's what I want to have. So anything can just generate animation, and I want to be able to use it. I will just require some naming, so I will just have to match things between the animation that I have and the DOM that I have. And for the functional class, I want to be able to do this kind of thing. This example comes from a demo that I will show you later. The goal is to make some kind of hula, and I want each element to know where it is, who is clicked, so who is the first to go crazy. And this way, I just want all the elements to do the same animation, and with those parameters, they're able to auto-calculate the duration. Okay, so basically, today it's really work in progress, really work in progress. I had really hard time dealing with the life of the scope. I don't know why he has so much problem, but actually, in a lot of directives, it's deleted before I have the occasion to do something with it, because actually, having functional class means that at a certain moment, at the end of the digestion, when everything is in the DOM, I have to reanalyze the class to say, okay, just put this value here, put this value here. And I'm just saying, I'm using $evil. And so if the scope gets destroyed, you have no more parents, he's offline, he's crying, and we can't do anything. And I didn't find a cool way to have access to the player today. There's definitely case when you want to have it, like if you want the user to directly interact with the current animation to speed it up or something. Or if you want actually your animation to have some kind of custom behavior when it's canceled, you want to know if a player is running or not, or when is the frame, where is the frame. Right. So for the demos, I will show you a square wave demo, material-like transition demo with UI router, and an image defragmentation. All right, let's go to it. Battery low. So the goal here was having some kind of a propagation of a click through different divs. So here I have just an ng repeat with various divs. Just plug in there, maybe. All right. So yeah, consider ng repeat, right? And when I click, I want this propagation, so it will be like this, or this at the center, or this at this corner, etc. And the actual only code needed is this to make it happen.
Can you make it bigger?
It's cut off on the left.
Ouch. All right. And bigger. Yeah. I'm actually hiding a lot of things because the animation, making the animation is pretty long because I have to make some kind of circle calculation in one length array. So there's actually a big famous service down here that is doing it with range and all. And what I'm doing is that I'm declaring my WaAnimation here. Yeah. And then I'm injecting the service that's going to make the circle indexation. I don't know how to say it, but you know what I mean. And then I have some function, and what I want to do is just return an animation with a certain rotation. Second example. Here we got material-like transition, so I'm going to click in a contact and I have the arrow that will stay with me through the page changing. And for this demo, I really want to not having my animation too I want each view to be well designed without animation, first of all. So I'm actually only trigger animation like until leaving and making some kind of fake things happen, like this actual element is actually here from the beginning, but I'm just hiding it because I know that during the transition there is another element that will be going. So working pretty well. I want to see the code. Yeah, all right. So I'm just using UI router. And I'm using some kind of propagation thing just because I don't like to put all the animation there because with UI view, the UI view is actually the one to be entering or leaving when you are changing routes with UI router. And so I just want to say, okay, if you are entering or leaving, just say it to your child so they can actually do the animation. So each page have a separate animation and can deal with themselves, by themselves. I actually have to do some dirty work here because the scope at the last decision get deleted, get destroyed. And so I had no more data about parents. And so on ng-click, I had to say, okay, give me the root state parameters I indexed of for now and stuck it somewhere else so I can just grab it later. I know it's dirty, but I don't find a way to just properly having like the moment it gets destroyed, like just before to grabbing the data. So it's almost the same thing for the lists. There is all the animation of the view here, and just the basic list with persons. All right. Last one. So I'm gonna full screen this one. The goal is from an image, having a recomposition of it with some kind of little acceleration. And it was funny because it was working too with gifts. So like a lot of gifts, I put this one. For the code, I used the directive this time. So we just have a different state, like one click to go and two directives that are going to take a magic number to say, OK, there's this much of destruction of the image at the beginning. And for the animation, it's a big, big calculation made there. I'm actually really took what was existing in CSS 3 because I just been inspired by some guy on CodePen. And he was making some kind of random in the pre-compiler of the CSS. So I just put a real random in it, and it's working well. So, yeah, that's basically it. Merci.